This video was sponsored by VectorToons.com, an awesome site where you can buy high-quality clip art, pre-made or custom, for your own personal and commercial use. You can use these clip arts for posters, videos, presentations, and anything under the sun. I've used this site myself on plenty of occasions, and I will leave a link down to each and every piece of clip art I use in this video down in the description. Check it out and help support this channel. Please enjoy the video. Welcome, any and all, to another video. Today, we are once again venturing far into the mythical and mystical creepypasta vault. Are you sure you want to do this? You cannot enter without a guide, and once you've committed to it, you can't turn back. You must know it is an extremely treacherous journey, and one not for the faint of heart. If you think you have what it takes, good. I will be your guide for the evening. My name is Dennis. And these are the top 10 worst Minecraft creepypastas. Number 10, The Real Secret, in parentheses, Notch Theory. Oh yeah, stories with blatant misspellings in their very titles are bound to be of immense quality. As you can tell, Marcus Notch Persson was the creator of Minecraft, and has worked hard to make the official release, and helped Mojang to continue developing it for him. But what you didn't know is that he is more of a secret person. Well, if he is a secret person, then how do we know about him? You wanna know why? Well, I tell ya. How kind of you. Notch did have a dead brother. He was found dead during the time Notch went to college. Well, that immediately debunks this story. Take it from an actual Swede, we don't go to college over here. We go to gymnasiums and universities. Eller hur, mina svenska tittare? He was put in a coffin and they put his computer with him. What, so is this like some modern Viking burial? Did they put the computer in there so we could take it with him to Valhalla? Secretly, his dead brother was a zombie, and made a character looked so simple that it still scares people. He uses a Steve skin, except it has a smile instead of a emotionless expression, and full white eyes and no pupils. He is mostly known as Herobrine, aka him. It is unknown what his real name is. Notch found out he was alive, and he promised to never give out Herobrine's real name in real life. How do you know about this author, and how do you know his brother is a zombie? He made jokes of adding in Herobrine, removing Herobrine, and he always made excuses for not having a dead brother. And how do you know about this? Also, why would Notch intentionally piss off his undead... dead brother? He also chose a pixel-like texture for Minecraft due to his likeness to the Nostalgia 8-bit graphics.
He got the idea of the skeleton because of a overrated troll pasta cliché. No! Stop it! This is so dumb!
He was also a spy. He stole as much minerals as he can and actually put them into the Minecraft using technology so power not even your computer can handle it. Oh well, that's cocky. He didn't make the pixel art, he actually took them in without permission and made a big 8-bit graphic 3D object. So when you play Minecraft, ask yourself, why am I even playing a game made by a person who wouldn't believe this? What? What does that mean? What was that? What was that story? Listen, if you want something that's even more frightening than this story, then go into the description of this video for a link to it, and check out the comment section. I dare you. Number 9. Minecraft Satan Edition. Probably the best title I've ever heard. I loved Minecraft. Notice the past tense in love. I know you might not believe this, but I stopped playing Minecraft because I found out that the devil was behind it. Let me explain. Yes, please do. One day I was playing with my friend Eric. I didn't have Minecraft for PC, I only had Xbox Edition, you filthy peasant. I wanted some way to play Minecraft on the go, so I bought Pocket Edition. Oh my god, now you're transitioning into mobile gaming? This is just getting worse and worse! Since Eric didn't have an Xbox, he had Pocket Edition too. So we decided to play with each other, viewing our creations, stuff like that. He asked me if I had a sort of parkour map. I did, so I scrolled down to what I called Parkour World. How convenient. As I scrolled down, I noticed a world simply called Hell. The screenshot for the world was the Nether, which was weird because it wasn't added in yet. So I simply deleted the world. Nothing happened. I kept trying to delete it, but it wouldn't go away. Since my friend was waiting patiently, I decided to ignore it and go to my world. After that, we played the parkour and screwed around. What was weird was that I found invisible blocks that would randomly replace stuff around the world. At first I didn't care, until almost the whole world was covered in invisible blocks. Eric couldn't do anything because he was trapped by all of the blocks. Luckily, I made a backup of the world just for this occasion. Again, that's incredibly convenient. I deleted the current world and we went to the backup world. But what was strange was that the splash text on the title screen said 666, of course! I thought it was a weird joke and moved on. When we joined the server, we got bored and started to spawn some cows. But what was weird was that the cows looked depressed. Depressed cows, yes. How do you even come up with stuff like this?
When they died, they would let out a distorted cry. We were both creeped out and decided to exit and play a survival server. When I joined, I had all my items as last time, but what was weird was that the sword was covered in blood. It wasn't even named a diamond sword. It was called the Bloody Murderer. I was freaked out, but Eric was even more, as on his Kindle he saw creepers. But these weren't any normal creepers, as their faces were full of tears. Freaked out, Eric ran away as the creeper exploded with its...
The wrong its.
Guts going out of its...
The wrong its again.
Body. He collected these items, which were named Bloody Sulfur. Eric came to my house, and where he looked at his crafting desk. If he combined a Bloody Sulfur with an arrow, he could create a decorative item, simple, lovely decoration. Eric was scared as much as I was. Suddenly, a cluster of zombies, skeletons, and spiders, all angry and covered in blood, approached us. They looked realistic, as if the mobs actually were real.
Are you sure you didn't just download a texture pack, dude?
We tried to turn it to peaceful, we tried to kill them, we tried to exit, but nothing would work. I wasn't stupid, of course.
That's highly debatable.
So I tried shutting off my iPad, but after 4 seconds, the game came back on with an ear-piercing scream. Suddenly, the chat said, "Server, Satan has joined the game." We just froze. Nobody else was in the house, and online was off. I looked at my iPhone. It then said, "Satan.
Everybody in this world is after you. Your family is not your family. You are a waste of life. Your brother shouldn't be in the same reality as you."
I was just about to get my hammer and smash the iPod.
Oh my god! Don't you just love how this dude's a smart device goes from being an iPad to an iPhone to an iPod in the span of seconds? Was spell checking just out of the question?
Until I heard a scream from upstairs. It was my little brother, Andrew. I went upstairs to find him with a sword in his body, bloody. There was text and Bay-Date on it that read, "Bloody Murderer." Back downstairs, I saw in the chat, "Server, Andrew has died." Then Eric said to me, "Oh my god, we must smash our tablets! Look at mine too!" I look at Eric's Kindle, everything was a negative color. The music was heavily distorted, and there was satanic whispering in the background.
Why is it that in all of these creepypastas, authors love to describe things as demonic or satanic, without explaining or making any descriptive additions beyond that? What does satanic whispering even sound like? Let your imagination run wild.
Just then, Eric accidentally mined the floor. All the monsters came in and brutally killed Eric. As they killed him in-game, he dropped dead in real life.
When you die in the game, you die for real.
Server, Eric has died. I then looked at my phone. I now only had 13 pentagrams in my inventory.
Only 13? What?
They all did nothing. Screams and creaks of help, along with loud demonic chanting, filled the speakers. I picked up my hammer and destroyed the iPad. My hammer caught on fire as I looked at Eric's phone, which said, "Satan.
Thought you could kill me? Silly human. They will kill you."
Just then my door opened, as the mobs came running at me. I died in the game, which caused me to get killed in reality. The chat text was entered a bit early, so I was able to read this, but not for long. Server, Danny has died. Deleting world, survival. Transferring all entities to world, hell. As I write this to you down in the underworld, before I become a devil's minion, please, stop playing Minecraft, as the same thing can happen to you.
Oh man, what a finish. What a way to end your story. Apparently, hell has computers lying around where damned souls can simply write their final words before becoming minions of hell. Great internet connection, too! I don't know about you, but I can't wait to go to hell! Number 8. Minecraft and the Magic Compass. Oh my god, guys, I'm so sorry. This isn't a story about Minecraft, it's a story about Minecraft. So sorry. The story. Once upon a time, while I was playing one of the best games ever, Mining Craft, it started snowing. This was strange because, as you know, no I don't know, I just started reading the story. I was building deep in a desert. I was scared and ran into my house for safety. I was scared of Hero Brine. Why do you immediately associate snowfall with Hero Brine? Are you sure you're not just paranoid? It's gonna turn out the snow is falling because of him anyways though, right? Hero Brian was a scary man with white eyes and stalking you to crash your game. Then my house set on fire and I died. Then I spawned in the sky and the game made a Bloody Mary face with a loud noise. This scared me badly. Then I got a text box that said it would kill me if I didn't get the magic compass and kill God. I am a Christian, but it acted as if it knew what I was thinking, and a hand came out of the screen, made a fist, and went back in. Then I got a map to find the magic compass. Are you guys ready for the most ridiculous and out of left field detail in any creepypasta ever? I don't think you are, but okay, here goes. There were many hardships along the way, including a large brown furry hand with testicles and arms. Told ya, you weren't ready for it. But I defeated him and progressed to the life tree, which grabbed me and strangled me. Ooh, kinky. But I defeated him with my amazing fighting skills. I beat all 7 Call of Duty games, so I'm good.
What?
Eventually, I found the compass in a dungeon chest with dangerous spiders in it and skeletal zombies. They were scary and they made me scared, and I ran out with the compass. While the compass led me to the fight. The arena was very bright. I was scared. When I saw God, I got even more scared and I spilled my chocolate milk all over the computer. But to my happiness, the computer was fine after I repaired it. I didn't want to be killed by the hand. When I faced God, I was blinded by a large white flash of light, but I persisted. I felt pain all throughout my body, and my hands started to bleed with pain. Oh my God, this is epic! I continued to strike God's chest, but every time I hit him, I felt the same pain in my chest. Oh, this is sounding very familiar to, NES Godzilla. I eventually defeated God and triumphed over the death, and the hand set me free. I'm happy to be reunited with my family. Were you ever separated from them? But I feel really uneasy now, and the feeling never left me. Epilogue. I now wake up in cold sweats in many nights when I go to bed. I kept waking up from scary dreams about these events that occurred to me. I wish this would stop. It's gotten so bad that I'm going to end my life! Well, holy shit, that came out of nowhere! Number 7. Minecraft Modcraft. Do you all remember when I complained about the lack of punctuation in my Metroid video? Well, you have not seen anything yet. I was on a Minecraft, you got it right in the title, what the hell? Mod site, and I was looking around until I found a mod called Craft. I was thinking Craft, huh, that's weird. So I looked at the description and it said Craft, so I installed the mod and started it, and the screen was normal, but the background was gray, so I started a new world, and I was in a desert, so I walked around until I found the woods, I punched a few trees and made a house, I made a bed and slept. When I woke up, I crafted a pickaxe, and went into a cave, I collected cobblestone, and I turned back, and a split second I saw that looked like a creeper, but it was black with red eyes, and the mouth was wider, so I went to my house and slept, and I was in a dream, it had skulls around, and I think it's a dungeon. I went forward, and I saw the creeper again, and it was faster than a regular creeper, so I ran back, and fell under the map, and I woke up, I went outside, and everything was lifeless, it looked like a wasteland, and I saw the creeper, and I looked at the chat, and it said, "Hello, my name is Craft, you notice what happened, but let's cut to the chase, Matthew, I am more powerful than you, I am going to haunt you until you're done for now. And now to finish my deed, you're going to be done for." So it ran at me and it had a smile, so I ran as far as I can until a bedrock wall blocked me. I looked back and saw it. It killed me instead of game over. It said, "My deed is done, Craft." So I went to the menu and went out of my room and it was locked. Well, then you didn't walk out of it.
I tried to open it. It didn't budge. I...
Oh my God. I just read 326 words without a single punctuation anywhere. This story is 613 words long. That's roughly 53% of the story with no punctuation in sight. And it seems as though this one punctuation was even a typo. Horrifying. This story was obviously devised as some foreign torture device to weaken the lungs of its victims.
Looked at my computer and saw the creeper's face, its eyes was bleeding.
Of course it was.
And was smiling, and it said, "My deed is done," until, and my computer went to my desktop, and my door was unlocked, and I was thinking, what does he mean by until?
F- Finally some punctuation!
1 year later, I still play Minecraft with that mod gone so. I guess I'll get some more mods. So again, at the Minecraft mod site, looking at mods when I found a mod called Mine. So I think it was the same thing. The description said, until, so I downloaded the mod and played. It's the screen popped up, it was the same old title, but I swore I saw the creeper. I started in a forest, so I will build a house, of course. So I made sure I had a sword in case the creeper popped up. So I went around getting food, and when he popped up, he said, "Hello, old friend, I missed you so much, how were you doing?" And I typed, "Good, fuckface," and he started running at me, and I went to attack him. He teleported behind me and killed me in one hit. The game over screen popped up, it said, "Until Mine comes." I finally know what it means. But then the creeper's face popped up with his face manga-led with blood with a big smile, and he said in a demon voice,
"Now hell awaits."
And then I blacked out. And then I woke up in the hospital, I saw my mom, I said, "Why am I in a hospital?" She said, "You black out, oh, do you remember that mod you made? Was it called Craft?" Wait, so did the protagonist create the mod in the first place? Is that the big twist we're supposed to take away from this story? Or could it just be sheer incompetence resulting in a jumbled mishmash of words and sentences? Probably the latter. Now, it's obvious that this story and most other stories on this list were written by younger people who may not have the best grasp on the English language yet. Trust me, I've been there myself. Therefore, I have to say, keep writing, okay? Keep writing and persist, because you will improve with each and every story you make if you really put your mind to it. Come back and blow everyone away. I believe in you. Number 6. Minecraft. Minecraft, a sandbox game that I loved in there. But sadly, after that experience, my name is John, and I played my Minecraft since I was a little kid. The very first versions of Minecraft were released in 2009, so I think it's fair to say that you are still a young person, but that shouldn't really be surprising judging by the grammar, formatting, and spelling on display here. So here is my story of my experience. Day 1. I was playing in my most successful world I just started a month ago. I made a wooden house with about 5 brewing stands on top of cobblestone, also a nether portal and a wheat farm. But one day I was putting the finishing touches on my enchantment table shed. I was putting up a sign that said, "The old creepy shack of enchant men." Enchant men. Then my game crashed before I could type a T in enchantment. So I turned off my computer and turned it back on. Then I went back on Minecraft and my world had been deleted. After a couple minutes trying to piece it back together like a puzzle, I couldn't figure it out, so I played some Left 4 Dead 2. Great way to unwind, friend. Day 2. Well, I didn't have very much to do on my computer, and I wasn't in the mood for any exercise or any mood for some derping with my friends, and Gary's mod was full of douches and guys with inappropriate sprays. That's very specific. I made a new world, and I spawned in a swamp, where I spawned in my last world. It looked a lot like the last world, and so any non-noob-like Minecraft player would do is collect wood. After that, I got coal and built a house, but at night when I ran back after mining, redstone was all over the dirt floor on my house. So I cleaned it up, then I made a bed and went to sleep, and after that I saved and quit. Went to bed myself while I was sleeping, I had a nightmare refracting Minecraft that was way too gory to type down on this story and very disturbing, like creepers in pain and growing arms that looked like ender arms and started walking on the ender arms. At least there were no fluids circulating through the vascular system. Day 3. Content deleted. Well, that's one way to save us all some time. Day 4. When I returned to my world, I spawned in the nether. This was bad, I wasn't prepared, and the only tools I had was stone and iron pants. Then a ghost appeared and shot a fireball at me and died in a one-hit KO. Then the game over. Game over? I thought the ghost died. Oh wait, it's just bad confusing grammar. Screen said, "Looks like you are worthless to enter this world, huh?" Suddenly a sharp pain shot up me. Shot up me? An emotional pain, huh? And I swear I could hear the scream of the Ender Man, and the last thing I could see before I passed out was 2 sideways rectangle purple eyes staring at me from the corner of my room. What? why do we even try to explain these stories, man? Let's just move on. Number 5. Glitch.exe.jpg. Two file extensions are not going to make the file any stronger, buddy. They're just gonna cancel themselves out. There was a boy named Noah Holmes who was on his way home from school. His bus was just getting off, and he went walking home with earbuds on and eating some candy. He got inside the house and started playing Minecraft on his computer. He was making a house, his usual normal day in Minecraft, but something happened suddenly on the top part of his screen. It said glitch.exe.jpg. He clicked on it in curiosity, and everything had gotten glitchy. His house was deleting itself, the blocks of the ground underneath him were falling and collapsing, and everything deleted itself. Even the inventory box, the main part where his character Steve was, his whole world was gone. Then he fell under the world and died, in which made the computer shut down for some reason. Then he tried starting it again, but failed. Again on the top left part on his screen, it said glitch.exe.jpg. He turned the computer off and went to watch some TV. With his parents not home, he knew that he would have to tell his parents sometime about what happened. So he started watching TV and suddenly, every single electronic device in the house shut off. It was pitch black in the house, so he tried turning the lights back on, but they didn't. Then he heard a whisper in his ear that sounded like a girl saying, "Aren't you glad you clicked that?" Ooh, kinky. Noah, getting very horrified, luckily found a flashlight out of the flashlight and ran out of the room outside. Then he heard the voice again, whispering,
"I'm the one in your games, Noah, and if you try to forget me, I will find you."
Do you like my woman voice? Noah started screaming and then he fell over dead, with his skin torn off and filled with a virus. Damn, that's brutal. The girl who had done this is never known. Some say she was a virus or a zombie, but I'm the only on who knew this, because I'm his friend who lived next street. I'm Jeff. Jeff? No, that's not the Jeff we're all thinking of, is it, right? I most certainly do hope so. We're not getting any answers though, because that was the end of the story. Yesterday I got a call like from my dog, like 101. Number 4, The Disc, Minecraft Creepypasta. Thank you for clarifying just what your story is about in the title. Makes much easier for me to find. Info. Warning. Everything here is the truest thing you will ever see. So if any people say this isn't, then you will regret it. That surely is convincing. Get ready for some truth bombs, children. The Disc, in parentheses, pasta. It was a normal day when I found out that my Minecraft account is hacked, in parentheses, hacked. So I even looked up used Minecraft accounts. Do you not have enough money to just buy the game again? I mean, I won't judge, man. Today's economy, buddy. Whew. There was an eBay page. Clicking it, it was a disc saying, includes a Minecraft account. It was €1.99, so I bought it with my credit card. Waited it to come. When it came, I popped it into my Mac. Did you really just buy a dodgy-looking-ass disc from eBay for €2 that will undoubtedly have a virus on it? It was a Windows Minecraft, so it didn't work, so I got my Windows computer, popped it in, there was a folder, I opened it. Wait, so you don't have enough money to buy the game again, but you have enough money to own two computers? There was a Minecraft applicaiton. It was named T-Phrase-Inum. Weird, maybe the guy who typed spelt it wrong by accident or he was just stupid. I don't want to make a joke in your expense, author, but nah, let's move on. I played it, the account was called Satan Slave. I looked it up in Google Translator to find out it was Japanese for- What? It's in clear English! Majin Slave, in parentheses, Devil Slave. Ooh, kinky! I was weirded out, so I continued. When it came on, it said Mojang in all caps. Then the logo went black and a Enderman ran across the screen, chasing a Minecraft player, Steve. It caught it, there was a huge splurt of blood for a second, until it came onto the menu, the Minecraft sign, Minecraft, was in bloody couleur. I was weirded to find it was real blood, so there was one world, it was called Do Not Play. I was thinking two things. My angel was like, no, do not play it, when the devil was like, go on, play it. I played it, which I should have listened to my angel, cause I spawned in a house. I went out a door, it was a land full of netherrack, I walked around. I saw an Enderman, suddenly my game turned to hardcore, the Enderman was chasing me, I ran as fast as I can, it teleported to me, killed me, and my Minecraft shut off. The end. This will be something I will never forget. Are you sure about that, dude? I just read your story and I can barely remember it. I went to eBay to find out who sold it to me. I found the guy who sold it killed himself the day he put the thing on eBay. I hope you don't find it and buy it. How is someone supposed to find it and buy it when you bought it in the beginning of the story? You probably didn't think that one through. Number 3. Bloodcraft. Oh come on, I didn't even get to finish the title. As I am a frequent Minecraft player, I wanted to try something new. I saw a mod that just lab-led a Bloodcraft. Oh man, this is gonna be a rough one. So I downloaded it, thinking it had blood when you attacked mobs. As I installed it to Minecraft, a notepad opened up, and in the notepad, a message poopaid up saying, this is your first mistake. At this point I thought it was from a game I downloaded, Escape from Lavender Town. Oh yeah, just name drop Lavender Town in a Minecraft creepypasta, sure! When I loaded the game, I went to go click single player, and all my worlds were replaced with the word no one can help you. Now at this point I was pretty scared, but I just kept playing. I decided to make a new world. As I opened up the world, I spawned in a room, and in the room was a very, very detailed head of a Steve player that was decapitated dead. Blood dripping on the floor, there was only one door and it led to black. As I walked into the black, the game started to glitch out, and out of nowhere, I just appeared in a sand biome. I just assumed that's just how the mod works. It didn't hit me until I was mining some iron, when a sign poopaid above the iron I was mining. It read, RIP Lonnie, which is my real name, and never put it in Minecraft before. This scared the shit out of me. I quickly exited Minecraft. Right after I closed Minecraft, I opened YouTube and started watching funny videos to calm myself. Then you're what? I just ignored it. You definitely did. You ignored it so hard you forgot to write it in the story. When I reopened it, I started a new world and deleted the mod out because it scared me after the world was created. I was in that some room somehow from the beginning of the mod, but the door led to a new room. There were painting on the walls of different people cut up and gore pictures. I can't take gore, so I was looking at... There was a pregnant no, I am not going to read that. It's just completely gratuitous, disgusting violence for no purpose whatsoever. Inexcusable. I shut off my laptop right away, but the sound kept coming in, getting deeper and more darker, when my computer screen flashed on. Computer screen connected to laptop. When a picture blinked of my brother dead in what looked like his room. I went upstairs and there he was dead. Limbs torn from body, no jaw eyes, looked like they have been burned out, and he was faintly breathing. I quickly called 911. When they arrived, he had already died. Ooh, that is heartbreaking. A character we hadn't heard of before and won't hear of again just died. Feel something. A couple months later, after his funeral, I had a nightmare of his funeral, but instead of him and the coffin, it was me, and everyone was crying. But wait, these are different people. I soon realized it was mine. You're what? When I woke up, there was a dead person on my floor. His eye was hanging out of his head, jaw hanging on by barley, and meat and skin. His guts spilled all over the floor. I called the cops and they showed up and handled the situation. After they left and my room was cleaned up, I grabbed my laptop and smashed it against a brick wall, and all I heard was, "You're still not free." I have nightmare of death every night since so realistic, the pain feels real when they killed me in my dreams. And then there are a bunch of dots, and then in parentheses it says, "Sorry for shitty spelling." Oh, dearie me. At least the author has some form of self-awareness. I mean, that doesn't make the story any better at all. In fact, it might just make it worse, since the author is blatantly admitting to laziness, but, Ooh, there's a bird outside. Number 2. Herobrine Horror. All caps is scary. I was playing Minecraft as usual. Yeah, no, everything was good until I made a new world. In the seed section, I typed Herobrine Kills. Why would you do that? Also, how is anyone not familiar with the story of Herobrine supposed to figure out who he is without any prior knowledge? I loaded the world, but it didn't load like it was supposed to. The loading background was peach black, dripping with blood. And instead of saying loading world, it said loading doom. When the world loaded in the sky, no clouds, just a bloody night sky. The moon was dripping blood. Fog was all around me. Are you in Silent Hill? I figured out I was in a graveyard, but no ordinary graveyard. It had blood everywhere. So I started to wander. I found a tombstone covered, ow, eye blood that said R.I.P. Herobrine. And then I saw something familiar, a ghostly figure in the fog. Then a tombstone appeared next to Herobrine's that said, R.I.P. Steve. Then Herobrine was running after me. I ran to a house hoping I was safe. Can you just go one sentence without f***ing up? Then something, nope! Weird happened, he blasted the door, and before I knew it, I was against the wall with blood everywhere. Herobrine was stonating in the doorway. Give me a death stare. And after 30 seconds, the screen went black with blood squirting and Steve screaming. After that, a text box came up. As you know, there are no text boxes in Minecraft. So it was not normal. This story is not normal. It said, "What have you done? Why did you do this to me?" The author didn't do anything though. Then in a flash I saw Steve all bloody with his organs spilled out and with his eyes ripped out. Then the words came up on the screen, "Only God can help you now." Then the game tuned off. And I never played Minecraft on PC again. Ow. That hurt. Please make it stop. Okay, okay. One more story, one more story. I did warn you that this journey would be rough, and it's time to finish it. Number 1. Herobrine the Real Story. Herobrine the Real Story. In 2009, I found a game named Minecraft. I was about to make a game just like this. I download it and play it. About a year later, Marcus Person made a update to where you can do cheats. My friend Marcus Person, oh yeah, sure. Do you also have an uncle who works for Nintendo? Give me a email that said, "Tom, you can't make another game just like this because it's the most played game on Java. You and I can go to a Minecraft party, okay, Tom." I had no idea Notch was so extremely bad at English. I mean, I knew he was Swedish like me, but come on, man. Later that day, I want to go to the Minecraft party, but I have to go to my job. I went to my job, but it was closed, so I went to the Minecraft party. So what was the point of including this quintessential I have to go to work subplot? Marcus said, "Why are you in this party?" "Because my job is closed." "That's fine, it's fine, okay?" "What?" said Tom. My manner opened the door and he was very angry. He headbutt me and kicked me in the head. I fell down on a cool grass. Fire was all in my face. Are you confused about what just happened? Too bad, we're continuing. 5 days later. My friend tell me, are you okay? I said yes. Ooh, when you need to tell your friends that you're okay, but deep down, you're really not. Later that day, I went to my computer and log into my Minecraft profile. I changed my skin to a Steve, but with white eyes. The end. Oh, what a twist, what a twist. Turns out this random wacker from the internet who no one knows about is the real Herobrine. Spectacular. Now, here's what really ticks me off about this story, and this is something that I have never seen in all of the years I've surfed the internet and read creepypastas. The author literally copy and pasted the entire story, word for word, and inserted it into the story again. Why would you do this? To make the story seem meatier? Did you do it by mistake? Did you have like a certain number of words you had to get to? What were your motivation for this absolutely mind-boggling decision? And that, my friends, is the end of our journey for the evening. Time to exit the vault for now before we suffer any major damages. It's been a rough one, and I hope you're all still alive and will be able to sleep tonight. Although that's debatable. I'd like to thank you all for watching and sticking around until the end of the video. Unless you skip to this part, then, I have no words for you. Thanks for watching, everyone. Stay awesome. Good. Bye.